30 years later. You have to start at the same time, yeah, I think.
Did you come back twice over there, or did you stay there for your fights?
No, I went back and forth three times. Yeah.
How cool is that? Do you ever think in Oxnard you'll fight in Japan?
You been out there?
Not to Japan.
I'm gonna be out there for 2 weeks.
I might come by to this
one. I'm gonna be
there for 2 weeks.
You're gonna miss Christmas. You're gonna miss Christmas.
I know.
I'm gonna be over there for Christmas.
That's awesome. You'll have a great time.
I don't give a shit about Christmas.
I'm telling Rick, you need to get me over there.
Yeah, I don't give a shit about any of the
New Year's. But you'll have Christmas out there. They celebrate it. You're just not gonna have it here.
I don't give a shit about any of that.
Okay, tell me about Josh's opponent, Joshua Franco. He has one belt.
Okay,
look, has a belt.
It's not official. Okay. It's not signed yet, but it's been approved by the WBA and the WBO.
And
everything
they like
is
it.
So now they're just finishing out details and stuff. So we're assuming that the fight is, you know, everything goes smooth from here on out. The opponent is Kazuto Yoka, WBO world champ. He's a four division champ. Really, really good boxer with good power. It's not an easy fight. He's had like five title defenses already of his WBO title. So it's not an easy fight, but.
Vita, those New Year's Eve fights have 80,000. Are you ready for that? Like 80,000 fans.
It's yeah, I've been watching their old cards.
Yeah, told you.
Like
am
that.
I right?
A lot of people there, but they're really quiet. We're not going to start when the bell rings.
Hey, you remember in Macau when they? You remember in Macau?
When this one starts right now.
Pita, you remember in Macau they told the fans when to cheer, when not to cheer?
Yeah, remember they had that little thing? Over here they're quiet. It's real quiet.
Different culture. That's cool, I'm excited. So you're gonna go out there the day of the fight, the week of the fight? Like
the week of the fight, like a week before the fight.
Japan, that's pretty cool.
The worst time of my life was coming back from Macau, China. That was the worst thing of my life. It was 34 hours from the time we left. The Venetian,
you guys
in Macau, China,
right?
So we got to the airport in Fresno, was 34 hours.
Okay.
Delays, okay. Sitting in the airport for 8 hours, waiting to see.
Pita.
Horrific.
Okay, so the night before the Big G comes to Macau, Pita, tell him the story.
Oh yeah,
I'm leaving. I'm waiting to get on some shuttle. The water's so green. You think it's like some kind of concrete. So I told Peter the night before, I'll go get the Big G. Don't worry, everybody's busy working. All of a sudden, as the ferry's leaving, I see Peter running on. Like how did?
That time,
let's go.
I was supposed to go pick up Big G like at 3 in the morning. At 3 in the morning, I was gonna go pick him up.
From Hong Kong.
Yeah.
Ellie was like, I'll go with you. I was like, are you sure? Like, it's really early in the morning and shit. He's like, yeah, I'll go. And I woke up late. I woke up like at 4, like at 2:30 in the morning, 30 minutes. It's like 45 minutes away. I was like, fuck. And I just fucking run to the hotel, like find a taxi and tell him, hey, I need to be here
you
in like 10 minutes.
Extra.
Like, I'll give you extra. He's like, oh, I'll do it. And we fuck. And then when I'm running into the ferry, you have to buy tickets. So some lady was like, hey, I'll sell you a ticket. I grabbed it and I gave her money. And I did. And I get there right as they're closing. And I'm like, whoo. And Ellie was already sitting right there in the front. Ellie was going to go without me.
Hey, the one thing it took me a couple days to realize when these girls come up to you in China and say, do you want service?
Yeah.
I don't know what
Pita, who has
service?
The most fun
you
want
to service my room? He came back with more than just souvenirs. Brandon may have some siblings out there. Macau was a trip. You know, Chip, what was the biggest trip in Macau? Two-thirds of the casino. The minimum to gamble was $300,000.
Oh, it was expensive.
What?
Two-thirds. Like, you only have a third with regular people. The slot machine started like $100, $200. Started that. Up to $800. It was the richest people in the region over there.
That's crazy.
$300,000 minimum. You're not spending that? You're not in the...
Yes, sir. Over here.
Yeah. And you know what's funny? There was no Chinese food in China.
They had
no Chinese food.
The food was good though. The food was good over there.
People were friendly. It was cool. They have their own monopoly money for the island.
Right here, the hotel where we're staying at, it's not a big casino like that.
Yeah.
It's not Nottingham.
Chepe, you need to take a loan and gamble.
It's a hotel with a few restaurants and stuff. So I'm actually more excited about this because we're gonna have to go out to go eat.
Yeah,
and stuff.
See the
we're
real
gonna
life.
Go train at the Taken Gym. Mr. Honda's already one more round after this one, and then he goes in. Mr. Honda's gonna set up sparring for us, so we're gonna Bam's gonna go with us all 2 weeks, so Bam's gonna be training.
Inui will be your new best friend by the time you leave.
So I'm really looking forward to it. It's gonna be badass.
Hey, I want to go just to tell Inui. You look at Bam. That's the guy that's gonna beat you. I'm just playing, everybody. Don't get mad at me.